Hey guys, Ryan here. I'm excited to pick back up on my Amazon merch mini series for 2020. Now, obviously, it's been a while since I did part one where I walked you through how to apply for an Amazon merch account. That's because due to the cerveza sickness, they had to close down their facilities for about 5 weeks. But now that they're back up and running, we're going to jump right back in. So in part two, I'm going to walk you through some design software that you can use to create Amazon merch designs. And I'm going to give you a quick tutorial of some of the basics you can use to create designs that sell. Hold on, before we start real quick, my name is Ryan Hogue. I've sold over $1.6 million on Amazon. Got to update that number. And I've been teaching at the college level since I was 25 years old. I teach web development, but I can also teach you how to increase your sales on Amazon merch. I've got a free mini series you can sign up for using the link in the description. I've also got a free public Facebook page where Amazon merch sellers are helping each other out to increase their sales and level up or tier up their accounts. Check out link in the description. Just wanted to make sure you were aware that I publish a transparent passive income report each month around the first or second day of the month, including my Amazon merch figures. So you get to see my sales, my revenue, my profit, etc. Last but not least, I wrote a full-blown Amazon merch course that will take you from beginner to expert. I pass along everything that I've learned along my journey. That includes selling $250,000 on Amazon merch and getting to tier 20,000, and includes a bonus section where I show you how you can automate the upload process. It is incredibly valuable, and you can find a link to it in the description. Last but not least, sorry, one last slide. Find your why. Why do you want to make passive income? This quote from Warren Buffett really speaks to me. If you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you'll work until you die. That's a promise, guys. So that's what's motivating me to make passive income. And Amazon merch is a big part of my monthly earnings. All right, back to lesson two. We're going to cover some design software and go through a quick tutorial so you can make designs for your Amazon merch products. So I want to start you off with a piece of software that's browser-based. So you don't need to download and install anything. It's done right from the comfort of your web browser. By the way, I love the web browser Google Chrome. I did mention I'm a web developer. Chrome is popular because it is the fastest browser, and it's also the default on all the Android devices. So believe it or not, Chrome has the largest market share of any web browser. All right, so you can go to bit.ly/join Canva. I've got a link in the description as well to get started. You can get started for free, but I will recommend considering upgrading to Pro after you've played around in Canva and you've kind of decided if you like it or not. When you upgrade to Pro, you unlock more features that are useful for your Amazon merch designs. But once you go to Canva and you create an account, and then you're going to need to create your first design. Now, before we start actually designing, you have to click that create design button in the top left corner, and you're going to want to input custom dimensions. Now, the dimensions that we're going to use for Amazon merch, I call these the default design dimensions because most of the Amazon merch products require you to design at these dimensions. Unlike other print-on-demand platforms, Amazon merch is specific with the dimensions of designs that you're uploading to their platform. Most products, including the standard t-shirts, require you to design at 4,500 pixels wide by 5,400 pixels tall. So get used to those dimensions, remember them. That's my recommended design dimension for all print-on-demand. Now, not all Amazon merch products, we're going to jump away from Canva for 2 seconds. Not all merch products require 4,500 by 5,400. Products like pop sockets and hoodies require different dimensions. What's cool about this is that you don't need to worry about resizing your designs and cropping them, etc. I've got a free, 100% free, don't even need to register, tool for you to use called Merch Resize. You can go to that website by going to bit.ly/merch resize. And I believe you have to do the capital M and the capital R, just so you guys know. I'll put a link in the description though. Literally, you drag drop your design. You say, I want to download for pop socket or I want to download for hoodie. Click the download button. It will resize it for you and you can download it. Also, if it's a pop socket, it'll put a black background for you as well. So very nice tool. Recommended to add that to your merch toolkit. I'll probably do a separate video later in the tutorial and I'll just go over some of my recommended merch tools. That would definitely be one of them. All right, back to Canva. So after we've created our design template at 4,500 by 5,400 pixels, go over to the background selector, which is, it's on the left-hand toolbar that you can see right here. I suck at pointing with my webcam because it's always backwards and the green screen is all backwards. But there's a background button on the sidebar. There's also just like a color block when you're looking at the design space, and it should just be white by default. Click that, select a dark background color, because, and we'll talk about this in a future lecture of the miniseries, but the data kind of shows that dark background shirts, like the one I'm wearing, they tend to sell better. And in order to have your design seen against a dark background shirt, you're going to need to design in really like a light colored design or a light optimized design. In order to help us do that, set the background color to a dark color. I just set it to black by default. All right, what are we going to design? We need some sort of a t-shirt design. So I went ahead to Amazon and I typed in funny quarantine t-shirt. This one came up first. It says, I like coffee and maybe three people. We'll use that as our design. So next, I'm just going to go to, by the way, look at this design. It's just text. This t-shirt sold probably, I didn't look at the exact numbers, but it definitely sold five figures and most likely in the six-figure range. Like, it was the number one product that ranked organically when you searched for funny quarantine t-shirts on Amazon. So do the math in your head. This shirt sold a ton, but notice how simple it is. Gray t-shirt, black text. I have seen that color profile selling really well on Etsy as well. So you may want to consider rendering t-shirts in that color scheme. That's always an option. I will walk you through the Amazon merch upload process eventually and show you how we can select the colors that we want our design to be available for on Amazon. So it doesn't just make it available for all colors of the rainbow. We get to actually decide what colors, meaning what color t-shirts our design is made available for sale on. All right, back to Canva. So we're going to click the text tool in the sidebar, and you will get a ton of different font options. What's cool about them is they give you these pre-selected font pairings that you see right here, and you can scroll for a long time. There's so many options. So what I did is I clicked this one that says cheers right here, and I used that cursive font, and I typed, I like coffee and maybe three people. And then because it's a font pairing, they'll typically drop like two or three fonts into the canvas. So back on the example here, it says cheers, and then underneath it in a different font, it says to the new year. All I did was I deleted the part that said to the new year, and I kept the cheers part, and then I changed cheers to I like coffee and maybe three people. Boom, this is one design. You could export this, and you're on your way to creating a text-based design that clearly is already proven on Amazon to sell well. That took maybe 5 minutes, right? That's how simple you can create your own designs that will actually sell on Amazon. Don't worry, by the way, we're not going through the upload process in this video. I'm going to break everything up into more bite-sized chunks. Right now, we're just creating designs. Before we download this design, or you know what? There's no harm done. Go ahead and download the text-only version. But I'm going to show you how you can upgrade this design in Canva very easily. Now, this is probably restricted to Canva Pro users only, so you may need to upgrade to do this. But on that Elements tab, there's a ton of pre-made graphic elements. So if you guys don't think you have great artistic ability, or you just don't want to spend time creating graphics when they're already pre-made and readily available right here, which, I mean, to me, that's nice. You know, time is money. Remember that. You can go ahead and click Elements and then click into the search bar, type in a word. I typed coffee because that was relevant to our design. And look at all the options. By the way, you can keep scrolling. There's a ton of these that you can use. So I pulled one of the coffee mug graphics into the canvas, and then I left aligned the text. And look at that. That took maybe another 30 seconds for me to do. That's how easily you can create nice designs in Canva. Now, you don't actually need to turn off the background when you export from Canva if you're exporting as a PNG, which Amazon Merch requires us to do as a PNG, so no trouble there. But what we're going to do next is in the top right corner, click the little download arrow that you see there next to share, and you'll get a pop-up. It says, how would you like to publish? Or you can click publish too. And then you're going to want to click download, and then you're going to want to set the file type to PNG, which Amazon Merch requires. And you're going to want to leave the size as 1x, so it'll be 4,500 by 5,400 pixels. And then I just realized that I was supposed to check that box that says transparent background, so my apologies that I did not do that before taking this screenshot, but go ahead and check transparent background, which I'm pretty sure, because I use Canva Pro. I'm pretty sure you need to be using Canva Pro for them to allow you to use the transparent background, so that's one another reason why you should consider Canva Pro. I think Canva Pro is only like $9 a month, so it's very affordably priced. I think it's cheaper than Photoshop, so you may want to consider that. Speaking of Photoshop, so that was it for our Canva tutorial. I went into pretty good depth walking you through it. In reality, once you're used to how to use Canva, it only takes a minute or two to create these designs. And with the graphic library that they have, you can create a bunch of different designs using different graphics and really hit a niche hard, meaning you can upload multiple designs in the same niche. So if we want to call this the coffee and quarantine niche, you can come up with different text and different coffee graphics and just start making a bunch of different designs like very easily. All right, so another piece of software that I wanted to recommend, and I'm not going to go through full tutorials for the rest of the software, because with that Canva walkthrough, you got the gist of what's important, guys. It's really the dimensions of the canvas that you set up and the approach to design. Simple text designs work. We'll do another lecture in the mini-series talking about how to approach design for merch, guys, but don't overthink the design aspect if you're new. It's easy to overwhelm yourself. Trust me, text designs sell. All right, you can get Photoshop using this link, adobe.ly/getAdobe Photoshop. I'll put a link in the description. And it looks like this. You're going to need to download it and install it. I think you actually have to download Adobe Creative Cloud now, and then it downloads through the Creative Cloud app. I love Photoshop. I've been using it for probably like 15 years at this point, so I'm just used to it. But you know, if you like the convenience of being able to create designs in your web browser, you can still go ahead and use Canva. You can also check out this free website called Photopea. You can access it going to bit.ly/getphotopea. It looks very similar to Adobe Photoshop. Like, huh, check out that resemblance. This is Photoshop and this is Photopea. It's interesting, right? What a strange coincidence. But Photopea is web browser based, so you don't need to download and install anything. Also, completely free to use. So that should definitely be on your radar if you're trying to go the budget route for your Amazon merch designs, because you can use this for free. It's in your web browser. Again, I'd recommend using Chrome, Google Chrome, because it's fast. And that'll get you started. That'll get you on your way. Last but not least, I do know some people are interested in designing from their mobile device. Go ahead and check out this app called WordSwag. All right. The only downside to WordSwag, it makes it very easy to create designs on your phone. The only drawback is that not all of the fonts available in WordSwag are approved for commercial use. All right, I've said my piece, but let me also follow that up with one thing. You can upload designs that are not approved for commercial use to Amazon merch. There's no automated checks and balances, and there's no manual checks and balances that say, wait a second, this is a, you know, we detect a commercial or a paid pay-to-play font. You know, did this person pay for the font? Can you show that you paid for a license? That never happens. So I'm not trying to like give you bad advice and say, oh yeah, go ahead, steal fonts that you're supposed to pay for and all that. But I'm just, you know, letting you know that not all the fonts in the WordSwag app have that commercial license. Do with it what you will. If you're looking for a mobile design app though, WordSwag makes it very, very, very easy to create nice looking designs from your phone with just a tap of a button. All right, guys, that's it for this tutorial. Next time in part 3, we're gonna go through the Amazon merch resources. We're gonna start with the royalty calculation page so that you know how much money you can expect to get paid based on how you price your merch products. By the way, before I wrap up, go ahead and check out Webull. It's my favorite stock trading app. You can also trade options. You can trade in after hours and pre-market. They're giving you 2 free stocks just for signing up and depositing $100. So you're basically getting, like, on average, the 2 free stocks are worth no less than $20. So you can get basically 20% of your money for free just for signing up if you deposit $100. So go ahead and check that out. Links in the description if you're interested. And that's it, guys. If I can do it, so can you. I'm just you from the future that took action. And, you know, you have more of a plan than I did. I didn't have somebody on YouTube telling me how to approach Amazon merch or my other FBA business, KDP business, print on demand business, etc. So guys, if you need help, if you need someone to show you the way, I'm here, I'm available. Drop me a comment, shoot me a message on Facebook, email me, whatever, and we'll be in touch. But anyways, thank you for watching till the end. Do me a favor, hit the like button, subscribe if you're not already, and I'll see you at the next one.
Passive Income School is open. Enroll now at riotsmethod.com. Thank you.